Hello and welcome everyone. So we were talking about Next.js crash course and we will be covering everything. So let's get started with the Nest CLI tool, which will give us the base project, and then we will start learning from that base project by adding the other building blocks of Next.js. Okay, so you can just quickly get started with this npm install -z Next.js CLI, and then you can just start the project with just simple command. It will give you the skeleton of the project. Okay, so let's wait for this to be done. Then, so in Next.js CLI options, there are many options, and the project structure will look like this. Like any other project, it will be using the TypeScript. So you will have a tsconfig.json, and you will have the package.json node modules and all the libraries. And when you do npm run start, it should be able to start your project. It is kind of same as like Angular CLI, where you can create a new module, new controllers, new services using this Next.js CLI tool. So this is done. So now if we do, you can just say Next.js project, and it will create a simple project. We will keep npm base. So you can see what all it has created. If you see the structure, so nest.cli.json, it is required, and tsconfig.build.json, tsconfig and build.json, like it's a TypeScript project, so it is really needed. And it has created these three things: controller, services, and module. So module is a root. Module contains the services and controller. Okay, this main root ts, where we will be bootstrapping this particular application. It's same as like we do bootstrap Angular application. So we pass the root module. Root module contains the controller, services, and all the other things. The other things we have is a test. We have E2E integration test using Jest. These are the E2E test case where we are using the request module and hitting the actual APIs, checking the status code, passing the payload, doing the data validations of the request. So we will be testing each and everything. Now if you can see, this is our Next.js project. This is how this look like. So it is giving you everything. You don't need to do anything: the coverage, debug, npm run build, nest build. And when you do npm run start, it should be able to start your project on some particular port. Okay, what other module, what other dependencies we have, like Next.js CLI, and we have Next.js core, platform express, reflect, metadata, and rxjs, which I talked about, the reactive extensions in JavaScript. So we should be able to use rx pipes in this project. And other things are the ESLint and some testing modules, like ESLint support for making the code look great, you can say. And if you see the src folder, here we can see the app controller and the app module. So this is the basic skeleton. You can just remove them or you can just keep them. So this is the root module. Similarly, in the project, what you will be doing is you will be creating the a different module. So here you will create a user.module.ts and user controller. I will just create a dummy services. So I created a user module, controller, and services, right? So this is app module will be the root module, where I have to include all the other modules. So you can say this is my user module. So I will be using some services like user controller. User controller, and here I have a user services. Okay, user controller is this one, and user services we have. And I will just convert it to user module. And then we'll just import this module. So we have user.controller.ts. I will just use the same controller definition here. So user controller, here we are defining the routes. Okay, my base route will be the user, and when you have a forward slash, you can say get user. This is the method which will get triggered. Okay, here we have user service, and the data will come from user service. I will just, this is a dummy service, so I will copy it from here. User service we have, so controller is dependent on it. What happens? Let's see this. And user service is importing this. So here we are doing a dependency injection. So I have a user service. And I will be accessing user service here. And user service dot some method that can be get hello. Okay, the route for which this particular request will be registered will be forward slash user and get. So it will be HTTP get, right? This is the controller. So controllers are the placeholders which will expose your services in form of routes. Here we can write get, put, post. So these are annotations provided by Next.js. Get, post, hello, you can say, right? So we are not checking any body and everything, it's just a dummy code we are writing. So user controller, user module. Now we have to import user service, user service, user controller. Let me just see what we are exporting from user controller. So user controller, we have to explain that in the user module and pass the same controller. So we have created a user module as a separate module which has its own controller, and these are the API endpoints we have created. So it is heavily using TypeScript annotations like controller. It has its own definition. Here we have a HTTP get, HTTP post, right? And what we are doing is, now you can just import this module here. Import user module. I will just define it and user module. So here it will be user module, and you have to just pass this module in the import. So this is same as look like we are writing Angular, right? We are creating the modules and putting that dependency there. Now if you see the main.ts here, we are bootstrapping our application. Next factory.create app module, this is the root module in the application. This is another module. So user module is passed to the root module, and this is the root controller. In the root controller, whenever the request is coming for forward slash, it will be responding with this message. And whenever the request is coming from forward slash user, it will be responded by this, because this controller, this user controller, is dealing with all the requests which are coming with forward slash user. Okay, and this is our service. This is main.ts. So this is how we can create a structured application. We just talked about two things here: controller, services, and the modules. Consider now we have a lot of other building blocks also of the Next.js, like creating the pipes, interceptors, filters, and DTO objects, and the integration of the MySQL and MongoDB, Mongoose module here. So you will be just, instead of writing these services, you will be writing some methods which will be getting the data. And whatever the third-party modules we are using, like Typo or a Mongoose module, Redis module, all will get registered in the root module. Okay, so this root module already knows that I'm using the TypeORM module and these are the entities. So you will be able to access those entities and access those NoSQL schema data from the services. So it's like an MVC pattern. You started from the root module, then you go to the controller. Controller will call your service methods, and everything is wrapped around a module. So, and app module is a root module combining all the modules together. Okay, so this structure looks very simple. Okay, tsconfig build, and we are using this tsconfig build. So it is just, look, it is extending the main tsconfig, and tsconfig is just a compiler options. Okay, the final modules we are compiling into the common.js, and it will just, when you do run the build, it will create a dist folder. Okay, and it will just compile and send the output there. Okay, so this is the basic building blocks, and these are the test cases we have written. I mean, we will talk about writing the test case once we are done with the API. We will include the swagger pack and all. This is our ESLint RC. So here, I mean, ESLint is getting deprecated and it is being migrated to the ESLint only. So you can see that we are using the ESLint parsers. These are the plugins we are using. It is extending all these things. Prettier TypeScript, ESLint, TypeScript, ESLint recommended. And we have installed all these in our package.json. If you see in the bottom, we have already TypeScript ESLint, TypeScript ESLint parser. These are in the dev dependencies. ESLint config prettier, ESLint config import. prettier is prettier RC we should have somewhere. Yes, some basic rules. If you wanted to add some more rules, you can add it here. And apart from that, we have ESLint RC. If you have other ESLint rules you wanted to add, put it here so we can have a common rules this available. Okay, so this is just a boilerplate code we have created. Now what we will do, we will build on top of this. So let's connect in the next video.